Oh, hi there.
Who is the strongest animated character? An age-old battle that has been waged but never settled. Well, I finally have the definitive answer, and we need to look no further than the recent slew of canceled movies. Warner Brothers has been on an absolute tear, canceling two basically finished movies, a Scooby-Doo film and the DCEU Batgirl project. But Warner Brothers aren't the only one canceling films well into production. The month prior to Warner Brothers' shocking move, the long gestating Popeye movie was scrapped. Now again, I ask, who is the strongest animated character? The first one that comes to mind is of course Shaggy, but I would implore you to check the scoreboard. Warner Brothers cancels a nearly completed Scooby-Doo movie and nothing happens. Shaggy is helpless. But within 24 hours of the director announcing that the Popeye movie was canceled, its entire 87-minute long animatic was posted to YouTube. Maybe it's his old man strength or the spinach that gives Popeye the edge, but whatever the reason, the one-eyed sailor with four arms of the gods would not allow himself to be disrespected. And today, we'll see how we got here, how Popeye beat generations of neglect, a decade of development hell, and the full cancellation of his movie, only for it to find its way to YouTube. Popeye the Sailor Man debuted on January 17th, 1929, created by E.C. Seeger for the comic strip Thimble Theater, quickly becoming the strip's biggest property. It got so big that by 1933, Popeye got his first adaptation in the form of a series of theatrical shorts. These shorts would prove to be some of the most successful of their era, being cranked out until 1957 at 231 shorts in total. Popeye would continue to be cemented into pop culture through the 60s and 70s, with two popular animated TV shows, Popeye the Sailor and the all-new Popeye Hour. But things would change. In 1980, he was given his first big-budget live-action adaptation, Popeye, starring Shelley Duvall as Olive Oil and Robin Williams in the titular role. Though a financial success, it was not received well and really marked the beginning of the end for Popeye's dominance. Since then, we've only gotten more poorly received entries, like Popeye and Son, the TV movie Popeye's Voyage, The Quest for Pappy, and the 2018 web series Popeye's Island Adventures. It seemed that Popeye just either didn't click with newer generations, or the character was being mishandled. But there was hope on the horizon. In 2010, 30 years after the release of Popeye's last big-budget feature film, Sony Animation Studio announced a 3D animated Popeye movie. Honestly, this wasn't a huge announcement. Things wouldn't get really interesting until 2012, when it was announced that the Popeye film would be directed by Genndy Tartakovsky. This is because basically everything Tartakovsky touches turns to gold. He's best known for his works on Batman the Animated Series and the Powerpuff Girls, and for creating some of Cartoon Network's most popular programs, like Dexter's Laboratory, Samurai Jack, and Star Wars The Clone Wars, and would later go on to direct the first three Hotel Transylvania movies. If anyone could revive Popeye for a modern audience, it's him. In 2014, Tartakovsky and Sony Animation showed off some behind-the-scenes work on the movie and released Popeye's test animation. It looked fantastic. They got nothing but positive reaction from fans. Tartakovsky said, "I couldn't be more excited by how it turned out." So, of course, Sony promptly announces that the movie's delayed and Tartakovsky is no longer directing. Now, there's a little bit of a misconception here that Popeye was canceled in favor of the Emoji Movie, but this is not true. The Emoji Movie was successfully bid on by Sony in July of 2015, months after Tartakovsky left the Popeye movie. Sony continued to claim that the movie was in development over the next 5 years. But after 10 full years of failing to get a Popeye movie off the ground, in 2020, Sony finally threw in the towel, passing the film off to Popeye's rights holders, who made the excellent decision to bring back Genndy Tartakovsky as director. And things seemed to be moving along. But on July 21st, 2022, disaster struck. In an interview with Decider on the second season of Tartakovsky's Adult Swim TV series Primal, in the final question of the interview, he was asked what happened to the Popeye feature film. And his response, basically, it's dead. Now, it's sad to see a movie get canceled, especially one from a character that has been so neglected in recent years. But movies get canceled all the time. It's just part of Hollywood. But what happened next, no one could have seen coming. Just 24 hours after the interview with Decider, the anonymous YouTube channel Chip Buddy posted the entire 87-minute animatic of the Popeye movie under the name POP112213 APML Screening. The video wasn't noticed until 4 days later, being shared across the internet before it was taken down. An animatic is basically a rough draft. It usually consists of storyboards with dialogue and a placeholder soundtrack. It serves to see if the movie works, if elements like the script, voice acting, and pacing are good enough for the movie to move forward. Based on the video's description, the animatic likely comes from an internal screening from the November 22nd, 2013 version of the film. The letters APML have yet to be made sense of, but it's believed that AP stands for Amy Pascal, who was the chair of Sony Pictures at the time. And even though there's no consensus on what ML stands for, I believe it stands for Michael Linton, the chairman and chief executive officer of Sony Pictures Entertainment at the time. This leaked video shows that the animatic was basically a fleshed out movie, with a ton of time and effort poured into it, and features the voice talents of Tom Kenny as Popeye and Aaron LaPlante as Bluto. The animatic starts at sea. Popeye is a baby and very sick. His father takes him to an evil witch in a desperate attempt to cure him. The witch saves the baby, but takes the child as payment. Popeye's dad steals the witch's magical gem, sends Popeye out to sea just before getting caught and imprisoned by the witch. Popeye washes up on shore and grows up in an orphanage, being looked down upon by his peers for being different, desperately wanting to fit in. As an adult, Popeye comes across the witch's gem, believing that it could lead him back to his father. At the same time, Bluto is trying to propose to a reluctant olive oil, but he doesn't have a good enough ring to please her mother, so Bluto steals Popeye's magic gem and uses it to propose to Olive, who unenthusiastically accepts. Popeye then seeks out Olive to get the gem back, but ends up kidnapping her, and since Olive doesn't want to marry Bluto, she makes up excuses to join Popeye in his quest to find his dad. The two eventually fall for each other, while being pursued by the witch, who's in search of her gem. In the end, Popeye defeats the witch, crashes Olive and Bluto's wedding, and finds his dad. The story ends with a great message of acceptance, but not for Bluto. The film ends with Popeye punching him in the face in slow motion. There was so much love put into this animatic, and some elements really worked. It showed off Tartakovsky's signature comedic action sequences, the message of acceptance is really well executed, the characters are sympathetic, and even though the animation is rough, it looked great. But there are also some elements that needed some serious work. The plot is progressed through really lazy narration that doesn't need to be there. There are a few unnecessary characters, and some of the jokes just don't quite land. I am really conflicted on whether or not the studio was justified in canceling the Popeye film. From a financial perspective, Popeye is not a highly recognizable character to kids today, and the animatic was not so good that the movie was a guaranteed success. It would take some exceptional marketing to get kids interested in seeing a character with so little brand recognition in modern times. It would be a gamble for any studio to put money into. All in all, I am so happy the movie didn't just disappear and that someone had the guts to leak the entire thing online. Since the animatic is dated to 2013 and the movie wasn't handed off to King Features Syndicate until 2020, there's a very real possibility that there are additional versions of the film in various stages of production. And just like everything in lost media, with each new discovery comes more to find. And I look forward to seeing what else the unreleased Popeye movie has to offer. Thank you so much for watching. This leak is really exciting for Lost Media and gives us hope that other recently canceled films have a chance of surfacing in some form. But really, the whole debacle begs the question, is Popeye a relic of the past? I'd really love to hear what y'all think about that. And big shout out to my newest top tier Patreon supporters, Vinny Cataldo and Edgar Vega, along with the continued support from the glumpiest of glumps, Miss Dana, MD the Dude, and Odesta Honeycrisp. Thank you so much. It truly means the world to me. This is Mike with All Things Lost. See you soon.